How you doing? Rick Denny here. So I'm going to give you a quick rundown on a little trick that you can use using, well, starting off with just two really standard sort of patterns. The pentatonic pattern, right? Okay, right now I'm playing like an A minor pentatonic pattern, but it is really, just think of it as a pattern, because if you put my fourth finger on that A and I play that same pattern, and now I'm playing in a major pentatonic. So I'm going to use both those major and minor pentatonic together like a overhead projector, laying one on top of the other, and I'm going to think in terms of using that process to play a jazzy style blues if you want to go that far with it. Okay, so I'm going to use those two patterns, that standard pentatonic pattern that everyone knows, and this one. You notice I'm not using maybe a fingering that you might associate in your book, because that's what I'm doing is more practical. Alright, it's real. So I'm just extending that pen, a little same notes anyways. And it's in the shape of an F shape. Okay. And so I'm gonna layer that pentatonic along with my minor pentatonic. My minor pentatonic goes. Major pentatonic, if I'm starting from that little extension. Right? So now, just in that little area, just right here. Minor, major, both. Minor, major, both. Minor, major, minor. Also see that you can continue this all the way down. You just keep on layering the two patterns together. That's just simply over a 12 bar change. You can hear it. Anytime you have a funky thing over one dominant seven chord,